Hello, how's it going? Whew. Hello, Bookish and Audie, how are you? Whew, I am like out of breath. I thought I was just gonna go make tea really quick, and then the dogs were out of food. And then I have loose leaf tea, well, it's like herbal tea, but I like spilt the chamomile everywhere. I'm a disaster. And then like I was rushing down the stairs, and then some of the water in my teacup spilled, so I'll just like need a second here. But how's it going? Happy Friday. Bookish, you're too funny. An evening stream, so, what am I even saying? Okay, so, I think on my days off, I'll be streaming probably in the evening, maybe like late afternoon time, probably anytime between like 3 and 6, I'm not really sure. Today, like, because Dad's at work and we're both on the same shift, and so once he goes to work, I'll probably just stream sometime afterward. Yo, what up, Weeblization? Oh my god, that has to be Mr. Bookish. There's no way that's my Bookish. But what is up? How's it going? But yeah, so I think that's going to be kind of the plan, is like late afternoon, evening type stream time. I don't know. That is not Bookish. That is certainly not Bookish. But yeah, so Dead and I are going to... Okay, there we go. Dead and I are going to work on just like, I guess like a work schedule, you might call it. Just like times of when we plan on individually recording and streaming and that kind of stuff. So right now, it'll probably be a little bit wonky. He was giggling holding my phone, so I knew he did something. Well, cause he said, I saw yo, and I was like, that's not Bookish. Can't be. And then holla, that's not Bookish. But hello, Bookish, how are you? What is up? Okay, my tea is still super hot. You know me so well. I think that was the one day Mr. Bookish had your phone. And he was like messaging in the chat. and was saying like stuff, and we were like, oh, Bookish is so sassy today. But then he started saying stuff that like I knew you'd never say, and I think after that I'm like, if it doesn't sound like Bookish, it's probably not. Audie, your car is dead? Oh, is it like so cold that it died? Cause it's very cold here today. Let me actually look. Oh, I actually found this morning a video I took at a stoplight. It warmed up. It warmed up to -2 Fahrenheit, but feels like -24 Fahrenheit. It warmed up this morning when I got up, which is like, I don't know, maybe like 11. It was like, felt like -37, so. It lives at my work parking lot now. No, that's its new home. That's so sad. Is it just the battery that died from being so cold? Or do you know, when did it die? Like, what the heck, dude? He loves to pretend to be me and shock people. Well, it certainly was shocking until I realized that it wasn't you. Ooh, I need to grab my chapstick. Give me 2 seconds. I need to go over there. Okay, but I'm sorry your car died, Audie. That's always like really terrifying. I was definitely nervous about my car too, because the battery just like isn't good. It's just like the cold crank amps or like whatever, like just are really low. So whenever it gets really cold, I can see the battery struggling because my headlights like shoo, shoo, shoo. But only when it's cold. Doesn't really do that when it's like with normal fucking temperature. Fucking wait on Monday when it warms up, dude. Like, I am so thankful that it feels like it's warmed up here, and it's like still feels like it's -24 Fahrenheit here, which is like whack. But yeah, hopefully you get your car straightened out and it's not too much of like a full-on hassle, because that's always the worst. Hunky, hello, hello, how are you? Happy Friday, my dude. Oh my gosh, you guys. So I did literally the dumbest thing I could have ever done in my life. We had these rolls that didn't have, like, they weren't sliced yet. And I thought, it's just one roll. I'll just hold it and slice it and I'll be careful. And my knife was a lot sharper than, like, I thought it was. And it sliced through the bread like really fast, and I wasn't really expecting it. And so I cut my finger a little bit right in the like crook of my like finger. And so every time I bend my finger, it hurts me. That was like probably the dumbest thing I've ever done. JD, what is up? I'm sorry, Eddie. I don't know why, but I just came in still sorry. Her poor car died. Between $150 to $250, dude, what? Oh my God. Cause like, yeah, the changing of the battery is like easy. Is it just like, that's how expensive the battery for your car is? Cause that's like whack. If it doesn't start on its own, oh my God. That's such a pain in the ass, dude. Literally cold weather just like isn't right. You know what I mean? Also, that feels way too expensive for a battery, I would just like to say. Whew, excuse me. It doesn't have a block heater, so also fun. Mine doesn't have a block heater either. I didn't know those existed until I moved here. And straight up, I'm like, what the like, why? Literally, why does that exist? I don't know. It's pretty mid-range. What? The battery for my car costs like $80. I don't know what that is like in Canadian dollars, but That's like pretty, I don't know, like affordable. But also I probably have a way fucking smaller car than you do. My car is like itty bitty. It's over 100. Why Canadian be like that? Like, why is the Canadian dollar so fucking whack? Okay. So I think the plan for today is to sew up the side seams and just like generally like fix that up and like just get that finished, if that makes sense. You know what I mean? And then I'm going to hem it. I think I'm just gonna hem it like where it's at. I don't think it's like a big deal. Even if like my the like shift shows, I think it's fine. I guess that's not like terrible. I still don't like it. I still just don't like spending money on like maintenance shit for my vehicle. Like, it's so dumb. But I got my oil changed recently and I have my new tires, and now all I need to do is get my car washed and get new brakes, and she'll be as right as rain, baby. USD for my new battery, 198. Ugh. I feel like that's still too much. Barney Sins in Canada, why are we letting you be a country? I just like don't understand why the Canadian dollar is like that. I don't know. I'm also not like an economist, so what the fuck do I know about literally anything? I just feel like shit's way too expensive, you know what I mean? Just in general, I think. Okay. And then for the interior seams, I do want to fell the seams so it's not like all ratty on the inside and like raw like this. Oh, I was like, why did Hunky get timed out for 2 seconds? Why does it say that I did it? But I remember. Okay, so sew up the side seams, finish the hem of the skirt and the sleeves, and then fell the seams, which I don't know if I'm gonna fell all of the seams like on stream, because it's kind of like fucking tedious. So I might, just depending where we get today, I might like start it. And then this will probably just be like the last of the construction of the Viking dress. And then I do need to put it like up to a vote, I think, for what color to make this. Because I'm thinking, like, I either want to do maybe like red, like, I don't know. It could literally be any fucking color. I think the only color I don't want to do is like purple, but I think maybe like more of like a burgundy, like magenta-y color is like maybe the closest I would get to a purple. But I feel like purple is just a really hard color to achieve, so I don't think I really want to do that. Barney Stinson, look at this Canadian money. Its bills are all different colors and the people are playing hockey on it. It's like you're asking us to laugh at you. Oh my god. I feel like, I mean, at least your money's like fun. Ours is kind of boring. You know? It's just like got old dudes' faces on it. And that's like literally it. Until 2015-ish, this was pretty par, and then yay, economic downturn. That's so fucking whack. I remember, it was a long time ago, but I remember being at a Barnes & Noble I don't even know if those still exist anymore. And I remember looking at the back of like a book, and I remember it being like $10.99 US, and then it was $15.99 Canadian. Pretty colors, and it's plastic. Barnes & Noble is surviving? Really? It has been literal years since I've seen like a Barnes & Noble, like truly. Okay, I think I'm pretty much ready to just sew up the side seams and then... Okay, so here's the plan. Finish the construction, right? So it's all done. And then I think maybe dyeing it and then doing embroidery. I think that's gonna be like the plan. I think doing embroidery down, like all around the neckline, maybe it like the cuff of the sleeve could be kind of nice. But I don't know if maybe I should have done that before. I don't know, I probably should have done embroidery on the sleeves beforehand, but maybe I'll do it on like the hem of the dress or something. I don't know, we'll see. Just received my Amazon, a kid book about ghosts I used to rent all the time in my elementary school. Oh, fun! The World of the Unknown, all about ghosts. That's so fun. Is that like Chapters Indigo books here? We have so many. I don't have any idea. All I know is Barnes & Noble sells books. That is all. Okay. Take another little drink of my tea. This tea is so, like this herbal tea is so clear. Also, it probably doesn't help. My cup is green and I'm sure the tea is like green, but it doesn't even look like it's steeped at all. Okay. So I guess let's move to the sewing machine and finish this baby up. I'm like really excited to dye this. Very excited. Ooh, classic 80s, 90s book. I feel like that's, I'm gonna have, they are the same company. Thanks, Google. Good to know. I had no idea. I've never even heard of like Chapters Indigo books at all, which is like crazy. Like, I've never even heard of that. But then also, it's like, I don't know. I haven't heard about fucking shit about shit. Okay. Boop. So, I'm gonna go over to the table. I switched all of my... I need to fix that. Hold on. I, like, switched my sewing table so it's, like, kind of up against my, like, work table. So I actually have, like, some room to, like, move around. So, there's that. And then I need to... There we go. Loosen that up. We'll sort of reserve our own stores still, but okay. Yeah, I'm sure they're like probably part of the same parent company, which I feel like happens quite a bit, but like they are their own companies, but still a part of the same parent company. I would guess. Oh, you can see the little doggos right over here. Look at them. Cute. Okay. I am really excited. And then I am gonna stream tomorrow also. I'm gonna try to stream earlier though, I think. Instead of like 5. I just kind of went on like an ADHD spiral a little bit. I like deadlift and I was like, oh, I wanna take a shower before I do anything. And then I took a shower and then I was like, wow, the bathtub's really dirty. And I was like, I should probably clean the bathtub out. So I cleaned the bathtub. Then I got a notification that my new glasses arrived in the mail. And so I was like, well, I'm gonna go run out and go grab my glasses. And so then I took my contacts out to try my glasses on. But now I'm sad because I think they're too big for my face. So I'm like, should I maybe return them and get different ones? I might have to like post a picture with my new glasses on and see what everybody thinks. Cause like, I don't know if I'm just like used to my smaller glasses or just like the shape of them. Cause I've literally had my glasses for probably like 2 years, I would say, maybe over 2 years. Let's see. No, I've had those glasses, I think, for like 3 years. So yeah, so I'm like, am I just used to seeing my face in those glasses for the last 3 years, or are these glasses actually big? I don't know. Guess I finally shipped my Switch. That's so exciting! Dude, that's so exciting. What's the first game you're gonna get? But yeah, so I just kind of like had a bit of a spiral. Animal Crossing, good choice. Love Animal Crossing so much. Yeah, so then I'm like, go try my glasses on. And then I'm like, shit, it's like, oh my God, it was like 4 something. By the time I had finished all my sidetrack shit, and I was trying to stream at like 3:30, right? And I'm like, I still haven't like eaten food. It was just like kind of a disaster. So tomorrow, anyway, the point of that story is that I'm gonna stream earlier. I don't need to shower. So I have like everything set up. If I end up not finishing this tonight, and we end up sewing more tomorrow, or if I just decide to do another sewing project tomorrow, I don't know, we'll see. I don't really have like another sewing project like lined up necessarily. But I don't know. I don't know how I feel. Cause I feel like sewing, but also I kind of feel like playing video games, so I'm not really sure what I want. Anyway, I should be streaming at a more reasonable time. And Mario Party Superstars, dude, hell yeah. Really want JD to get Animal Crossing. I feel like JD, are you even interested in Animal Crossing? I feel like I could see, there's a part of me that's like, yeah, I could see him being wanting to play Animal Crossing, but there's a part of me that's like, would he want to play Animal Crossing? I don't know. Dude, it's been so long since I fucking played Animal Crossing. I've just been like coming home and then like passing out pretty much, like having a drink and then going to bed. Like, after work, there's like a couple of nights where I was trying to watch, what's it called? Hunger Games, like the Hunger Games series. And I like had a half a glass of mead and passed the fuck out. Woke up, the movie was over. I was like so tired. There was almost a whole glass of mead left. But yeah, so I've not played a whole lot of video games, which makes me like kind of sad. But I'm gonna try to play some video games before Dad gets home tonight, I think. I do have to clean the kitchen still. I don't want him to want to. I played the one on DS, didn't get into it. I feel like definitely the one for Switch is like way better, for sure. It like, I don't know. There's just like a lot more to do. It feels a lot, I don't know, like more engaging. but I don't know. That's just, like, my opinion. Like, because I had the one for DS also. Obviously, like, you guys know that I was also playing that on stream before I got the Switch, but it's just, like, not... Like, I don't know. Like, I felt like there was kind of, like, a nostalgic fun to it, but I definitely have to say the one for Switch is, like, 1,000 times better. I mean, Dad didn't want to play Animal Crossing and had no interest in it, and he started playing it, so I feel like that's got to say something. I mean, you could, I know it's like kind of a pain in the ass, but if you wanted to, you could always just change your like system clock so that it's during the day. That's what Dad did when he was playing on night shift. Because he would just log on and then switch the time to a couple hours like later, so it wasn't like, I don't know, it was just like daytime. So that he could also enjoy the game. Oh my gosh, Adi! Thank you for the resub, dude! Fucking 3 months. Haven't finished Metroid Dread yet. Best Nintendo game of the year. I don't play my Switch enough. Yeah, I mean, if it's just not like a console you play a lot, I guess that's like fair. Personally, I love my fucking Switch. So, that's like what I'm all about. Like, I want to get games I literally already own on Switch. Like, I told Dad I wanted to get Skyrim. And he's like, yeah, but you already have it for PC. And I'm like, here's the deal, though. And he's like, it's better on PC. And I'm like, but here's the deal. I probably would not stream Skyrim. I would just play it, like, on my own. And you know where I'm going to play it on my own? I'm going to sit on my fucking couch, on my Switch, watching a movie or a TV show in the background. Probably watching Outlander. And I'm like, that just feels like it makes sense, you know? There's like a little bit of like a hole right there, but honestly, it's probably fine. I could tack that down if it ends up bugging me, but that side's done. When I'm home, I'm on PC. Yeah, see, that's what I'm saying is like, it just depends on like what you kind of tend to gravitate toward. So it's like, if you're not, I don't know. I feel like if you're not playing your Switch enough, like I totally get it. Since I got my Switch, I have been on my PC like absolutely like none to play video games. I definitely much more prefer playing on my Switch. Now I just have to convince him to get it. Wait, what? I just found out one of my friends is Diablo 2. What? Oh yeah, dude, okay. So, I am like so surprised how much stuff is on the Switch. I guess like I'm just so used to like Nintendo just having like Nintendo games and like not having like anything else. And so I was like pleasantly surprised that like Skyrim is on Switch, there's like Diablo on Switch and like all kinds of fucking shit. Which just, I don't know, makes me really excited. people sew without sewing machines? That's what I'd like to know. Oh my God, okay. So, I don't know what was going on, but Dad was in here and he was asking questions about, I don't know. Anyway, I had some stuff like on my dress form and like some stuff was like pinned in place and he touched something and one of the pins just like kind of popped out. And, and it fell on the ground. He's like, I'm always so scared to come into your room because like you just drop sewing pins and you don't even care. And I was like, dude, it's not that I don't care. It's just like hard to find them. Like it's a fucking carpet. Do you know what I mean? I was like, I always look for them. And so I was like running my hand across the carpet, which usually just kind of makes them like pop up or I can like feel them. I have never been like stabbed, like impaled while doing that. And he was like, what? You're like a psycho. Like running your hand across the carpet like that. And he's like, why don't you just get like a magnet bar? And I'm like, I know people have said that to me before. And I was like, I just forget. And so he brought me down like one of our refrigerator magnets. I was just thinking, cause I was looking at my pins and I was like, literally just having them stuck in there like that, they're gonna fly out. It's not cross platform on Switch, weird. Yeah, so weird. I learned to be, but so yeah. I feel like I very rarely mean Sue. Oh my gosh, you guys, I found out the coolest thing. I'm gonna grab my little pin tin really quick and then I'll tell you my cool thing. My coworker, or one of them, I found out, so I had brought one of my like, my little Japanese study notebook to work. And when he came in, we're switching shifts and he's like, oh, who's learning Japanese? And I was like, me. And he was, and then he started speaking Japanese and I was like, oh, like, I'm so sorry. Like, I only speak like a little bit of Japanese. And he asked me how long I had been studying. And I was like, truthfully, if you like gather up all of the time I've spent studying, it's really just a couple of months. And he's like, okay, so very new. And I was like, how do you speak Japanese? Like, did you just learn it or did you live there or like what's up? And he was like, I actually lived in Tokyo for 3 years. And I was like, dude, what the fuck? And I just thought that was like the dopest shit ever, which kind of like made sense because English isn't his first language. I'm not really sure like where he's from originally, but the way he speaks English is very like how Japanese people speak English, just like the cadence and everything. I don't know. It was just very interesting. I thought that was very cool. And I am very excited to have somebody to kind of practice Japanese with, I guess, that I can just like in passing say things, you know? Hunky, what is going on? Wow, Hunky's just like on a roll. Diablo 2 isn't cross-platform, cross-progression. You keep playing the same character in different console or PCs. What? That's kind of crazy. That's cool. Adi, oops. Or I'll burn you at the stake? Jesus Christ. Hunky, no. I love how Hunky also still just like doesn't even stop though. He's just as like fucking gambling. All right. This is just like kind of a question I was just thinking about, because I was just looking at this and I was like, oh my gosh, like I can't wait for it to be done. And then I was thinking about the dyeing it colors or whatever. Can I do a poll in Discord, or do I have to do like a third party poll? I feel like JD, you would know, right? Can you do polls in Discord, or is that like not a thing? X always got ragey at me because I was legit better than him. Oh my god, that's funny. I always like was a little bit sad that in high school, like I never got into the games that like people were, that were popular. Like I didn't have like a computer when I was in high school, so I didn't really get to experience some of the games. When I would go to my dad's house though, I would play World of Warcraft. Like my mom had a laptop, but it couldn't really run World of Warcraft. So that made me sad. And then when I got old enough to buy my own computer, I bought a laptop and then played there, but that was like it. Which is like sad. I always really loved like PC gaming ever since I was a kid. So I never got to like experience like Diablo 2 or anything. My siblings tried to shun me from playing Smash Bros. With them because they couldn't beat me. Ooh, excuse me. Why don't they just put you on handicap? You know what I mean? Like, if you're that good. Like, we had a friend like that. Whenever we would play with him, we had to give him fucking handicaps because he was, like, so fucking good at Smash Bros. That, like, nobody ever wanted to play with him, just regular. They salty. They hate you because they ain't you. What? Okay. Is it the movie? What fucking movie is it? It has, old squinty eyes, Franco. It has Franco in it. And then, why can I not remember the other guy? Anyway, I feel like it's that, is it just called The Dictator? No, that's not right. The Interview? Where he was like, they hate us because they ain't us. But then he said, like, anus? Seth Rogen? Yeah. James Franco, thank you. Okay, I'm so bad at names. I'm sorry. I just know, it's The Interview. Okay. I just, like, think about that sometimes. And, like, I only saw that movie, like, once. And I'm like, I hardly remember it. But I just remember, like, weird, like, random parts of it. Like, the honey pot when he's like, are you honey dicking us or whatever the fuck? I don't know. Just like, whatever. I don't know. What the fuck? James Franco and Seth Rogen are literally the most out of control people ever. I just feel like they're never serious and it's just always a meme. My high school girlfriend's brother was so good at Smash Bros. 64. He could beat me, my friend, and my girlfriend all against him with a 150% handicap on him. Holy shit. He should have fucking gone into esports before esports was even a thing. But yeah, that's my story. I can never remember James Franco's fucking first name, and I don't really know why. That's just a thing, I guess. And then I don't remember his little brother's name either, but they look fucking identical to me. I just call him Little Franco, because, I mean, I can't remember James Franco's first name ever fucking either, so why would I remember his brother's name? I don't know. Dumb to figure out how to set up a handicap and didn't even think of it. I mean, that would have been the way to go, though, if you had thought of it.
Since Adi, hope we will share a new apartment.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I saw that you were moving into your new apartment. Firstly, congratulations. That's so exciting. And secondly, I can't wait for the fucking photos. I always love when people like move into like a new home. I mean, if you guys couldn't tell already from me loving The Sims, I do really like seeing people's like houses, like their layouts and stuff, and just like, I don't know, like architecture and like interior design is just like really fascinating. Wow, so that was like a lot easier than I thought. So that's all sewn up. Oh, I can't hem this until I fell the seams. Okay. That's gonna be very tedious. Okay, so at least I can do the sleeves. I can finish off the sleeves because I don't have to do anything. Well, actually no, because I have to fell that. Okay, well, okay. Let's, I guess, go work on that for another hour.
Got everything set up, utilities, internet's being installed. Dude, hell yeah.
And you hired a mover, dude. That's like dope. I do have to say, like, having a mover is like truly like the best thing ever. Okay. So, I want, okay. So to fell a seam, so I have these like extra wide seams on purpose, like to actually fell them. Like that's why I made them so wide. So on one of these, I'm going to cut it in half and then I'm going to take the longer part and then wrap it around and then sew that down. So that the seam will be like encased, if that makes sense, like wrapped around like that. So it'll be like all nice and neat and pretty. The sleeves I'm going to have to fell by hand. It's just, that's just gonna have to be a thing that I do. Same with probably, IKEA would be the best $300 I've ever spent because fuck you hauls. Dude, fucking moving with, like having a mover move you is just like the best. Did they pack up your stuff or did you pack up your stuff and they're literally just like moving it? I'm guessing for $300, they're probably just moving it for you, right? Okay. Here's a real question. Do I have my stuff packed and they'll take it out and move it in? Dude, that's dope. Okay, here's the question. Do I bother felling the seams or do I serge them? Cause I'm pretty sure that's just 100% cotton thread. So it will be dyed. I'm pretty sure it's cotton. Actually, I'm not so sure now. Do what you want to do. I don't know what I want to do. Because here's my, because I'm all about the lazy. Yeah, because here's the thing. It's like, the felled seams look good. Like they really do look nice. They're just tedious. You know what I mean? Because I'm not going to do it, obviously, completely traditionally, because I have a fucking sewing machine. It's the goddamn 21st century. So that's what I would do, is like cut it in half and then roll it over and then stitch it down with my sewing machine. However, the sleeves I'll have to like hand stitch. I'll show you what my other one looks like. It does look good. Okay, so all of these seams are like felled, so you can see like this like big wide kind of seam or whatever, and then on the inside it basically looks the same. Like it's just like a nice, I don't know, you know what I mean? Like it just looks good. I think they're, because like that's how seams were being finished, you know, back in the day, so it like does look nice. However, I just kind of don't want to. And if I'm going, but okay, here's the thing. What did the leper say to the sex worker? Keep the tip. Oh my god, that freaks me out. Hunky, who taught you that? Audie. Oh my gosh, Dad was so funny. So he was using my sewing table and stuff to like cut up some fabric. And he was like, yeah, I was in there. And then the dogs just laid down and like surrounded me, like around, while I was like cutting. And he was like, if I were you, I'd put up a baby gate and not let them in there. I was like, but I feel like bad. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know. Like they want to be in here with me. I don't want them to be lonely. I think maybe, okay, here is my fucking, here's my compromise, I think, for the sewing. What if I fell the seams on the like skirt portion of the dress? Like just because that I can literally just sew that down and it's easy. And then I serge the sleeve seams. And probably also the gussets. What did I even do here? My neighbor has been mad at his wife for sunbathing nude. I'm personally on the fence. Oh my god! That is scandalous, Hunky McChunky. Okay, so this is like fucking comical to me. So I'm like, here, I'll just search the parts that are hard to fucking sew as a compromise. That's literally what I did with this. What is wrong with me? Oh, I didn't put gussets in this. Fuck, I forgot about that. This was like a totally fucked up garment I made. It's really soft though. So there is that. Yeah, all around the sleeve. I surged it. That's funny. I just find it comical that I just had the same fucking idea again. Feeling very lazy today. I could have done so much. Instead I watch YouTube, The Net, and played Animal Crossing. I feel like with as much as you do all the time though, you deserve time to like, you know what I mean? Just like relax. I definitely wish I had been way more productive today. Just because I have not really been super productive during the week. But, you know. Okay. I think the sleeves, I don't think make nearly as big of an impact, to be honest. I just don't think that they do, so I'll probably serge all of the inside here. And then probably serge around the gusset. And then just where my gores are. My godets, my gores, my whatever. Just this like triangular portion. I will fell all of these. I do feel a little bit conflicted about this one in the middle. Because, like, what direction do I make it go? I guess I could just make it go toward the back. That seems like that makes sense, you know? Like, these two will go outward, and then this one goes toward the back.
Catch up on YouTube last night. You posted a video. Bailey Sarian posted a new dark history video. There's a new casual gribbles video. Wow, good grammar, Audra.
I feel that. I have not watched you, like, sat down and watched YouTube in so freaking long. If it makes you feel better, I think my video I posted is like 15 minutes or less. So it's not like a big commitment. Yeah, 14 minutes and 39 seconds. So that's pretty easy. But yeah, so it's not like a huge commitment. It's literally, I mean, you'll see, it's just making that corset belt. I think that, I don't know what I'm saying. I think I'd like to redo that project. I think that for the sort of just like journey of sewing, I think it's like a fine video. It just like the end product, I'm just like not super excited about. And then, yeah. Watch Demi's video, Holly Madison, few year with ears, couple that lived at Disney for whole year. Okay, so Bookish, I have a question about their videos. Do they ever like have a video of like them being at Disney, or do they just talk about it and it's just pictures? Because I'm like, was kind of hoping they would have like video. Oh, my nose is itchy. Ooh. Okay, so I guess it's time to get to cutting. But yeah, so I think we'll just get done whatever we can tonight, and then, yeah, I think this will probably just be the last Viking, like, Viking dress construction stream, just because, like, I don't know, it's basically done. I feel like nobody needs to watch me, like, fold up the hem and then sew it down, you know what I mean? I think I'll do maybe like a 1-inch hem and then fold that over twice. So it'll be like it'll appear 1 inch, but 2 inches of fabric will be taken up and you'll be able to see the undergarments underneath. They have a vlog that discusses each day. On that they share videos and pictures. We're trying to watch their videos, but like when we were watching, they just didn't have like any video like at all, which I thought was like weird. Okay, I think before I get started doing this, I'm gonna run to the little gamer's room and I will be right back. Except the humidity. I like humidity. It does not bug me. I prefer it. Okay, I will be right back. Okay, we're back. Ghosty, did you see my message on Discord? Oh, don't lick me, thank you. How's it going? How are you? Hello. Okay. But yeah, how's it going? How are you? What's up? Also, poor Ghosty. I just woke up, I can check it out. It's not like a big deal. I was just wondering if you had seen it or not, because I can just ask you now. That was actually my question, if you were planning on streaming today. That was still a thing happening. And if so, what time? But what time is it in Japan? Oh my God, I was coming out of the bathroom and I like went to turn off the light as I was like walking out and I just like scraped my knuckle like all along the little door thing after breakfast and whatnot. Do you have like an estimated time of 9:45 there now? Okay. Gotcha. Hello? Okay, I think I need to let the dogs out really quick. I think they ate and now they have to go potty. But yeah. The Fiend should give Ghosty her first hype train today. Okay, here's the deal, Ghosty. I'm gonna be real with you, dog. I need to know when you're streaming, because I need to know when to raid you. 2 hours from now? That's perfect. If like 2 hours is about the time you'll start streaming, then we can all just raid you and head over there and then fucking hype train it up. Well, I guess you know what fucking sucks? Is I don't think we can hype train you until you become affiliate, but you'll get to affiliate really fast, so, but we can still hype it up in the chat. Okay, I'm gonna let the dogs out. I'm gonna be right back.
You guys have to go potty?
Yep, Isaac does. Let's go. It is cold outside. Be glad to have you there anyway. Sounds good. Gonna get to affiliate in like a week. Yeah, cause like, what are the affiliate requirements? I can never fucking remember. It's like 3 average viewers or something. I don't know. I don't fucking remember. It's like stream on like so many different days, average viewers, and then something else. But I don't remember. I know partner is like super hard to get to, cause like you have to have an average of 75 viewers in like a 30-day period or something, which is pretty difficult to get to, I think. And then you're not even guaranteed partner, because then you have to like apply and then Twitch basically checks out your application and says if they'll accept you as partner or not. But then you go like into an exclusivity contract and
I don't know, man. We are looking for streamers who aren't yet partners, but who have at least 50 followers over the last 30 days. Oh yeah, 50 followers, 500 total minutes, 7 unique broadcast days, and an average of 3 or more. Yeah. Yeah, so if you streamed for 7 days in a row, and you had at least 3 people viewing you all of those days, and then had 50 followers, like you could potentially get it in a week. I don't think that that's impossible to say so. Which is cool, because then you get channel points, and you can have, like, people can sub, and you can do the emotes, and it's like fucking, I don't know. I just like all the art stuff, you know, that you can have, all the fun, just like customization is cool. I mean, you can have like donations set up like beforehand though, so you could still potentially make money before becoming an affiliate. Through like Stream Elements or Streamlabs. I don't know who you're going through specifically, but yeah. I notice I have a second follower that brings me to 2, because you're gonna start streaming too, right, Audie? Let me look. Hold on. Now I'm curious. Okay, hoping by summertime. Hell yeah, dude. Divine, hello. What is up? How's it going? How are you? I feel like it's been a while. Because ghosty, just ghosty bender, right? Not any crazy spelling. Dude, literally, what the fuck? I'm like, question, why in the fuck using Stream Elements? Dude, good fucking call. I like Stream Elements. Oh, here we go. Oh, maybe not. Why will it only let me fucking report you? I want to go to your fucking thing. There we go. Oh, I'm already following you. Yeah, Ghosty already has 15 followers. She's like already on the way. I'm doing good, Divine. Motherfucking Sunburn. What is up? How are you? Audie. Okay, let's do this. This is such like a weird... I feel like I did, but also I don't know. Ooh, bada bing, bada boom. And then I think if you're like following people, it just like notifies you, right? Or do I have to? No, it notifies you when people go live. But yeah. Wow, got a fucking party up in here. Up in this bitch. Had school today? How was school? How's that been? Oh. Goodbye. Sorry, Sunburn. Ghosty and Hunky are running off. Not really running off, more like sailing off into the pirate sunset. Where did I see Audie's message? There it is. I was looking at mics and cameras, needed PC, my bestie's ex-hubs is an IT god, and he would be able to help me with that. Yeah. I mean, it all just like depends on what you're doing, I guess. I know like the basic, so I guess if you just have like quick basic questions, like I might be able to answer them. But
if it has anything to do with audio, I probably can't help you. Sorry. Have you watched the new Spider-Man? I have not. We were trying to actually go see the new Spider-Man on Christmas, but then a storm kind of rolled through, so it was a little bit sketchy to be driving 30 minutes into town to potentially get stuck there. Happy New Year. Yeah, Happy New Year. Ghosty, I'm a handful. Ghosty, just from at least how you portray yourself online, I cannot envision you as a handful. But then again, like, you are an artist, and I know how artists can be, so then there's like a part of me that could like believe it. I just feel like you would be like wild, like that you wouldn't be like high maintenance, that you would just be like kind of a crazy person. Like, you're just like out here for a good time, you know what I mean? One time I went to a movie theater and they interrupted the movie and said there was a lightning nearby. That's kind of spooky. Ghosty, I'm needy. Okay, but aren't you a Leo though? What a, from my experience of Leos, I would say that Leos are generally pretty needy. Oh, what's happening? Okay, no, we're good. I just kind of panicked for a second. Oh, I forgot to, I'm just cutting shit out, so it's like not even like it matters. Whoops. Guess I'll say Sunbird then, we're both Leos. Dude, what the fuck? And you're a Leo, and Bookish is a Leo, and Dead is a Leo? Holy shit. Well, they're Leos, so. Dude, what the fuck? Leos do attract other Leos, though. I think you guys just have, like, Leo radar or something. It's, like, weird. Ghosty baby, do it. I guess that's just, like, I don't know, match made in heaven, right? Leos, with Leos. Okay, what the fuck? The fabric underneath keeps like getting somehow like stuck in between my scissors and this fabric, and I'm like not really sure how the fuck that's happening. I think this is what, working a 14-hour shift and then coming home to, would you still love me if I was a worm? Oh my fucking god. Dude. I just, like, when I see, like, TikToks like that, I never fuck, I just don't understand. Because I'm, like, I am, like, just surprised that Dead loves me right now, as I am. I'm, like, that's proof enough. You know what I mean? So many Leos. Oh, I'm a Cancer. Which is funny to me because two of Dead's best friends in the whole fucking world are both Cancers. They are his fucking favorite people in the world. So, not even like almost surprising. Wait, what just happened? No, it's fine. I'm panicking for no reason. It's fine. Same, Demi. Same. My brother is a Cancer. And you said you guys get along pretty well, right? I'm a fucking Capricorn. I don't get along with fucking anyone. And Taurus, because I'm full of bullshit. Yeah, you are, hunky. Few humans give me a heart attack. I thought okay, this is so stupid because it's not like it wouldn't even matter. It wouldn't even fucking matter. So I thought I just like cut the wrong side of the seam and then I would have to fell it the opposite way that I wanted to. And then I thought I like cut something off I wasn't supposed to, and I just had like a panic moment because I just forgot what I was cutting and I thought I fucked it up. My brother is one of my favorite people. See? Leos and Cancers. I don't know like what it is, if it's just like the like fire and water sign kind of situation, like opposites attract type deal. You know what I mean? I honestly do not know who Capricorns typically get along with. I don't think it's anybody. Your sun is in Taurus, though? So then you're... Ghosty, when's your birthday? When is your motherfucking birthday? Because most people go by their sun sign. Your brother seems like he would be one of my favorite people. I feel like the stories you've told, I think, I think I would like your brother. He says they're supposed to hate each other, Scorpio and Aquarius. Are they still married? Are they like, or I guess that's assuming they ever did get married, August 11th. Okay. Wait, what do you mean your son is in Taurus? Your son isn't in Leo. What? Per my friend, my fiend birthday list. 3 days before me. Holy shit. Because bookish, you're a July Leo, right? Or are you an August Leo? Because I feel like August Leos and July Leos are different. A July Leo? Okay, yeah. Oh, an August gal? Okay. Maybe a divine. Maybe that's what I was thinking of. There's like another... No, it was my old boss. She was a July Leo. That's who I was thinking about. I was like, no, there's definitely like another like feminine, like female woman person that I was thinking of that was a July Leo, but must have been her. Maybe my moon is Taurus then? Oh, I remember my chart was all over the place with different signs. I mean, that's usually most people's charts are like, not like all over the place, but usually you have like multiple different signs in your chart. I'd be willing to bet your moon is in Taurus, which is crazy because Dead has a Leo sun Taurus moon. Taurus, Virgo, Scorpio, and Pisces. Grounded, stable, and supportive signs that Capricorn knows it can rely on. Which is like funny. So one of my best friend, my sister is a Scorpio. One of my best friends from when I worked at Bed Bath, Scorpio. My best friend, we just like get each other on like a whole other level. He's a Virgo. My mom, Dead's mom, and one of my sisters, Taurus. So, yeah. All of those people I tend to really enjoy. How do you find out what your moon is? Okay. So if you go to Google and you type in birth chart or maybe natal chart, I never really remember what I type in. Sometimes it's natal, I think sometimes birth chart. It'll have you put in your birthday, the time you were born, the place you were born. And then it calculates your like birth chart, and you have like your sun, your moon, like Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, like you have all the planets, and then your signs are in those planets. It's like a whole thing. Yeah, you share a birthday with my youngest sister, Hunky, which is like crazy. I do think like it's fascinating. I know like I can understand like why people don't believe like in astrology, but I do think it is very interesting when you start to see like patterns in astrology. Like for instance, like from my experience, Leos just attract other fucking Leos. It's just like a big, like, Leo party all the time with Leos. And it's interesting to me that a bunch of people who are Leos found, like, mine and Dad's, like, reading, and, you know, he's a Leo. I just feel like Leos attract other Leos. They're just like Leo magnets. Raymond, hello. What is up? How are you? Welcome, welcome. What's a crack-a-lackin', as they used to say? Dude, when did that even happen? Oh my god. Okay, so speaking of back in the day, I saw this TikTok that was like songs that are turning 20 in 2022. And I was just like, you know, out of curiosity, there were some songs that are turning 20 that I'm like, they weren't already 20 years old? Like, Hella Good by No Doubt is turning 20, and I was like, really? Like, that wasn't already fucking 20 years old? I could have sworn that song came out in the 90s, but guess fucking not. I was like, No Doubt was still a band in 2002? Like, what the hell? Like, what's even going on? Thank you, Unky. You're doing fine? Glad to hear it, Raymond. Glad to hear it. Okay. Just got a little further to go. I think I'm gonna just snip-a-roo this here. Like that. Yeah. That's fine. It's fine. It's good. We're fine. Potty mouth. Hunky McChunky, I am an adult and I am allowed to have a potty mouth if I would like to. And that's what you get to do when you're grown up, is cuss as much as you fucking want. Or as little as you want, you know? The world is really your oyster. How is you? Me is good. Me is good. Not feeling particularly productive today. I literally didn't do fucking shit. Never ate an oyster, so I wouldn't know. I mean, you're landlocked. I wouldn't recommend oysters. That kind of freaks me out a little bit. I mean, I can't really complain. I eat sushi and I'm landlocked, but whatever. Mind your fucking business. Dude, that's what I'm saying. Sometimes it be like that. Sometimes it do. Yeah, I just, like, couldn't sleep last night, and so I slept until, like, 11. And then I woke up, and then, I don't know, Dad was doing whatever. And then he's like, oh, can we switch our lights that we have? We have, like, these little, like, Chinese lantern, like, paper lantern lights over, like, in the corner. And I was like, yeah, we can, like, switch them. And so then that was, like, a thing. And then we just, like, sat and talked. And then it was like, holy shit, it's, like, 2 o'clock and you have to go to work. Oh, no. I just broke my necklace. I'll have to fix it. Sad day. Sad day. Probably shouldn't have been fucking with it so much, but I can't help it. My sun is Leo. My moon is Pisces. That makes sense. That makes sense. Okay, how the fuck do I want to do this? I should probably cut everything before I start pinning stuff. Okay, let's do that. Oh, you guys, I forgot to... I forgot to take out this. Oh, I forgot to take this out. Hold on. Where in the fuck? Where is my seam ripper? Hello? Is that? No, I have like fucking 20 of these. This is unbelievable. I probably should have this here near my sewing table. Oh, here it is. It's by my sewing table. Audie, I fucking quit. No, rib necklace. I'll just have to just solder it back on, which is like good to know to like for the other ones is maybe just to go back over them and like make sure they're like really soldered on there. You know what I mean? Treat the pups. Holy shit. Okay. The dogs are outside. So, I'm going to rip this thread out. I forgot to rip out. And then we can go get them and then give them a little snack. Bink. Because they really like to be outside. I don't think they've really been outside too much today. It's been so cold, I feel bad, like, really, like, letting them just, like, be out there, you know what I mean? I know they, like, enjoy it, but I'm, like, with the wind chill, it's, like, negative 37, so that feels like I don't want you to be out there. Oh, shit, double treat the pups? Holy shit. I'm, like, kind of surprised Hunky didn't also treat the pups, but I'm guessing he's saving his for when I go, okay, I have to go fucking clean my kitchen. He's gonna say, actually, you can't because I treat the pups, so you have to come back. That's what he'll do. That temperature is just rude. Dude, that's what I'm saying. It was so fucking funny last night. So there was a basketball team staying at my hotel. And they're from like out of state. They're from a state that does not get this cold. And she was one of the chaperones, like whatever, like came up and was like, I'm gonna buy a couple of beers, like cool. And she goes, you from here? You born and raised here? And I was like, no ma'am. And she was like, oh, so you choose to be here. I was like, no, ma'am. And she's like, well, why are you here? And I was like, here for, like, work and stuff. I was like, so it's not really, like, necessarily, like, a voluntary choice. And she was like, okay, got it. And she's like, you ever thought about moving somewhere down south? She's like, you ever lived somewhere down south? And I was like, I did used to live in Texas for a while. And I don't know, it was just, like, kind of fun because I'm... She was like, oh yeah, where'd you live? It was Texas. And then I guess one of their team members is from San Antonio. And it was just kind of like a fun little like connection thing. But she was so funny when she was like, oh, so like you choose to be here. Hunky, me? I would never. They're huskies, they love that shit. Okay. But like negative 37 degrees. You know what I mean? Like, you're like taking temperature away. Like zero is just like, you know what I mean? That's what it feels like. Is like zero is like the default, right? The just like non-existence of temperature, which I know that's like not really how that works, but that's how it feels in my brain, kind of like numbers, right? Zero is just like the non-existence of a number. Then when you have like negative 37, you're like in debt 37 degrees. That's what it feels like. Like, I'm in debt. I'm in temperature debt here, and I don't like it. It is how it works. I mean, but that's not really, like, how it works, though, because there, like, still is a temperature. Like, my skin is still feeling a temperature. Like, I am still feeling hot or cold, you know what I mean? But like also temperature debt. Zero degrees and Kelvin is truly absence of heat. Oh my god. I'm a fucking scientist. Need to hydrate? Oh my god, bookish, thank you.
You better be start getting excited. Wait, what? Claudia, swear to God, what is going on? Honky, are you harassing everyone? Raymond, I too can read. Dude, I'm not convinced I can read. Okay, oh my God. So I'm just really excited about a lot of things, and I feel like I haven't talked to you guys in a while, so I'm just gonna tell you a lot of random bullshit about my life. I hope you're ready. I feel like that's just kind of like all of my streams anyways, so I feel like everyone just kind of comes prepared, I feel like. So, I've been pretty actively, I would say almost daily practicing Japanese, and I can now read like 23 kanji, I think. I can read hiragana. I should really be practicing my katakana, but haven't really been. So I'm not as good with my katakana, but I can recognize some words in katakana. I do need to just like fucking practice it. Do some fucking flashcards. Maybe that's what I'll do. Flashcards. But anyway, so the program I'm using gave me like a block of text. Like a fucking goddamn, just like a block of just Japanese text. And I could fucking read it. How exciting is that? Divine, congrats. Thank you. I hope that was for me. Just trying to get him back my sensors. Wait, what? Oh. For some reason, I just, like, my brain did not read Hunky, and I was like, wait, you lost your panda? I just was very confused. I swear I can read. I can get me, but you can't. Book is very proud of you. Thank you. I was telling Dad how excited I fucking was that I could I can read Japanese. Like, how cool is that? And then I was telling him like how like exciting like that feeling is of like, even though it's just simple text and it's like not really like saying a whole lot of anything, but just like the comprehension of reading another language, knowing what the words mean, and you just like, some of the words I even just like knew it. I really should not put this near my fucking head. Just like knowing it without like actively translating it into English, if that makes sense. So it was just like the word for like time, I guess, or like, I don't really know how to explain it. It's weird because I feel like there isn't like an exact translation. It's like time or hour or o'clock or whatever you want to call it, is G. And I learned the kanji for it, and it was really exciting that like I just saw the kanji and I just like, my brain was just like, didn't really like translate it, but it was just like, my brain was just like, time. You know what I mean? It just like knew. G? Yeah. I learned it with my brain. Audie fucking got him. It is really cool. Dude, learning... One of my favorite fucking pastimes is learning another goddamn language. So I was telling Dad, because we want to learn Spanish together. And I was telling him, like, I'm just so fucking excited to, like, get, isn't the word for time like G-con? Well, okay. So like, if you wanted to say like 9 o'clock, it would be like Kuji. Like that's like the time for like 9 o'clock. Raymond, time's up. That feels ominous. So it probably is like G-con, but I guess like it depends on like the context probably. At least, like, I mean, granted, I'm not, like, super fluent, so whatever, like, level I'm at right now, I haven't learned, like, that specifically. Time's up? That's what you said? Wait, what? Me say time's up. I gotta go for now. Well, thanks for hanging out, Divine. We'll see you later. Have a good night.
But yeah, so like that's what I'm kind of learning is like telling time. My god, that's like painful, but I love it so much, Ghosty. The context. I'll try to join you later. Okay. I don't know how much longer I'm gonna go. Just depending on, cause if Ghosty starts in like an hour-ish, I'm gonna raid Ghosty. So that's like the plan. But if she doesn't, I guess either way, I'll probably just end in like an hour-ish anyway. Oof, Ghosty. That was good though. That was like it was like painful, but it was like good though. You know what I mean? I just like appreciated it and I don't want you to stop. End? Like the stream? Like be done streaming. Just cause like, I need, oh my god. I wasted so much time today. I have so much shit to do. So I need to clean the kitchen. So I told Deadla, I was like, yeah, I'll do the dishes and clean the kitchen before you get home. I haven't done that. Don't tell him. I have a cabbage husband now. Hey, that's better than like, I don't know, like a shoe husband. He could be a shoe. You know, at least cabbage like tastes good. I can't imagine shoes taste very good. I don't know why you'd be eating a shoe, but like, whatever. She fails us, we go to plan B. Keep streaming till this time tomorrow in hopes of getting Ghosty to stream tomorrow. That's right, Ghosty, the pressure's on. I don't stop streaming until you start streaming. Nah, that's a joke. That's not real. My cabbages. Dude, I need to watch The Last Airbender again. But yeah, I think either way, I'm probably just gonna end in like an hour-ish because I need to do the dishes. And I also told Dad that I was gonna study Spanish tonight before he got home. I think I'm just gonna do review for 30 minutes though, because it's been like fucking months since I've studied any Spanish, so I don't fucking remember anything. Literally the only thing I remember from Spanish is encantada, which is like, it literally means enchanted, but it's like nice to meet you, like enchanted to meet you. I used to be like kind of a fucking asshole. I used to think that like, have I watched any Black Sails with Dead? I have not watched anything with Dead. Don't underestimate the power of cabbage. I feel like, what kind of power does cabbage have? You know what I mean? Like, what kind of power would you say? Raymond Tori. I know Tori is like, that's not really like Tori. Tori is bird. Tori is like a Tori gate. Pretty sure. Maybe not. Maybe I'm pronouncing those wrong. One of them is a bird, one of them is a gate in Japanese. Yeah, boo. Listen, I'm watching Outlander. That's where I'm at right now. Watching Outlander. Black Sails can come next. Okay. I acknowledge this. Oh no. Oh, poor Bookish. I think the like RNG gods are just like not in your favor. But yeah, anyway. Oh, I was saying how I used to think that when I was like in high school, I was like 16. I was like, I don't think Spanish is a very pretty language. Blah, 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 this and that. But I've definitely like, and I also used to think, and like JD, don't fucking shoot me, but I used to hate French, like as a language. I thought it sounded really ugly. So that's just how I used to feel about languages. Like, I thought some of them weren't pretty. Oh, Raymond, you're taking off. All right, well, good night. We'll see you later. Hope you sleep well and have a good night. Cocking gun now, sorry. Okay, I don't think that anymore. I do think, okay, don't fucking shoot me. I do think that French is a little bit overrated. You know what I mean? Like, the way people are just like have a boner about French, I think is like a little like, it feels just like a little, like inauthentic, I guess. You know what I mean? Now he's showing her true colors now. Yeah, now you guys are in too deep. Now you guys have to stick with me. You guys care about me as a person now, so now I can tell you that I think French and Spanish is ugly. Nah, that's not really true. I used to think that, but I was kind of just like trying to be, you know, like in high school, it's not overrated, but it's a pain in the ass. I just think that people like, I don't know, people are just like, oh, it's like the most beautiful language, which I like, yes, I think that for some people it can be a very like the most beautiful language. Like, I think that's an opinion people can have. But like, I just feel like for everyone to collectively be like, that's the like the most beautiful language seems like, are you just saying that because someone else said that? You know what I mean? But I used to like just be like a shithead and try to be like counterculture just for the sake of being fucking counterculture when everybody was like learning Spanish and French in school. And I was like, well, I'm gonna learn German. I mean, I do think German is a beautiful language. I do, like, I don't know. It's like, for me now as an adult, like, loving all of these different languages and the sounds of them, it's like, I feel like for me, I don't think I could pick, like, a favorite language that I think is, like, the most beautiful. Because I really do, like, I like the sound of French now. I like the sound of Spanish. What really did it for me for Spanish was the fact that, like, nice to meet you is encantada, which is, like, fucking enchanted. Like, how magical is that? French is really complicated. It's a really hard language to learn. So I'm going to start with the easy ones first. The easy Latin-based languages first and work my way up to French, probably. So we're learning Spanish right now. I was also learning German in high school. We're the same person. Dude, okay. Every day I am convinced more and more that like, I am just like the same person as like you and fucking Ashley. Like, there are just some people that I've like met on the internet that I'm like, are we just like the same? France don't really want foreigners to learn French anyway. Well, fuck the French. I'm gonna learn French and they can suck it. And that's just that. Cause like, here's my thought. Especially if, oh, here we go. I kept getting like snagged up. Oh, I fucked up. Oh, nope, here we go. Here we go. Bada bing, bada boom. Okay, but if I want to travel to a lot of different places, like, I want to know at least the basics of, like, the major languages, right? So I'm like, okay, what are the cultures that colonized most of the world? That is the English, the French, and the Spanish. So I already have English down. Learning Spanish, want to learn French. Whoa, 500 fucks to give, baby. Or maybe I'm like 500 fucks less to give. Not really sure. There's nothing you can say for me to unlove you. I may not like everything, but bookish is love for all the time. And that's why we love you, bookish. German is a beautiful language. If you want to sound like you want to kill someone when you're asking them, whatever. That is not what it sounds like. I used to, okay. I don't really feel like this anymore. I used to genuinely think that like French sounded like you were speaking it with peanut butter on the roof of your mouth. Hunky's lurking. Bye, Hunky. How dare you? Dude, I'm sorry. It's just like sometimes you have opinions in the past, you know, and they're not great opinions to have. But I definitely don't feel like that now. Like, I want to learn French, and I don't really think it sounds... Hunky. It's like, it's different now. Like, once I started, like, researching languages and, like, where languages are being spoken, like, in the throat and mouth, and kind of, like, I don't know, just, like, the culture behind languages, I'm, like, I feel totally different about languages than I did when I was, like, I don't know, 15 years ago. Oh my god, Hunky fucking up shit and then noping the fuck out of here. Solid move, dude. Classic Hunky. Web presenting same tenants in four languages, English, Spanish, French, and German, and they always end with the German, and it feels so aggressive. Okay, I do have to say that German, like, does have some kind of, like back of the throat sounds, which I feel like sound a little bit more aggressive, and I do think they are funny when you have, like, where they, like, compare the languages saying the same, like, word or whatever, like, hospital, and then you have, like, in German it's Krankenhaus, and then, like, an ambulance is a Krankenwagen. Adi, ooh, stretch, thank you. I'm about to go get the dogs also. Oh my god. Ooh, I think I just stretched that yawn right out of me. Okay, I'm gonna get the dogs. BRB. It's very cold outside, so they may not want to come in. I don't know. They've been pretty good about coming in lately, but be right back. Gonna get the dogs, and then I'm gonna treat them. Okay, they just, like, lost their fucking minds. Freya's, like, zooping around. They're crazy. She, like, came in and just started, like, running circles around me. Whew. I attempted to teach myself some French for you, and dyslexia was like, girl, what are you thinking? Yeah, French is, like, fucking crazy. I don't, all languages kind of seem crazy at first. I do have to say, the more I practice learning, like Japanese, for instance, the easier it's getting to learn it. Does that make sense? Ooh, excuse me. Okay, you guys want a treat? Hello? Anybody out there? Hello? Freya? Do you want a treat? They literally don't care. Do you guys want a fucking treat? Hello? Like, are you guys there? Oh, Freya wants a treat, huh? Wait, you have like a little tuft. I need to get it. There you go. Hello? Yeah, like what the hell? Isaac, do you even care? Okay, come over here. Back up, back up, back up. Sit. Stay. Nope, lay down. Stay. Stay. Wait. 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 Freya. Isaac. Good job. Alright, up. Shake. Good girl. Other paw. Other paw. Other paw. Other paw. Other paw. Good girl. Speak. Speak. Okay, back up. Freya, speak. Freya. Stop. Knock it off. Speak. Freya. Speak. Freya. Speak. Freya. Speak. Freya. Speak. Okay, stop. Fucking holy shit. Speak. Freya. Freya, speak. Shh. Freya, speak. Good girl. Alright, Isaac. Up. Shake. Good boy. Other paw. Good boy. Speak. 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 Good girl, you did it, you fucker. You guys are out of control. Get it together. Oh my god. Ashley, hello. Making noises against her Japanese dog coat. Maybe that's what it is. Because it snapped up when we heard the tin and went back to his Chewy. Oh my god. He's like, it's like he knows what's going on. He's just a brat. And he's like, I'll get up when it's time for the treat. Only having fun. Yeah. I'm having a good time. My god, Freya just like fucking, what the hell? She scratched my leg. I'm probably gonna need to disinfect it, to be honest. But Ashley, how are you? I feel like it's been a while. What is up? Ooh, she drew blood. Okay. I'm gonna go clean my leg and put a band-aid on it because I'm bleeding. And she has dirty little dog feet, so I will... I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Ghosty. Okay, that was like, not that like it freaks me out that she scratched me. I'm just like, ugh, she's got dirty little creepy dog paws, you know? They're creepy little dog claws. Okay. Wow, what a day. Ashley, how have you been? How are you? Whew, okay. Okay, right. I need to cut this bottom one, but since I fucking stitched it at a half inch, I can just cut the stitches. So I don't really have to guess too much about where I need to cut it. Isn't that nice? Because, like, to fell the seams, you want to have about half of the seam width, and the half of the seam width is an inch, so I need about a half an inch. Okay. Whew. What a day. I'll tell you what. Oh. That was a little wonky. That's okay. It's gonna get covered up anyway. Oh my gosh, I am so excited. So when Dad gets home, we're gonna have popcorn and we're gonna watch The Matrix. And I've never really seen The Matrix, so I'm excited. And I think he probably had it on stream and like told you guys like what's up, but we got stuff and made like grog. And I made a drink. We were sitting there and he's like, "You know what grog basically is?" I was like, "What?" And he's like, "It's basically just a margarita." And I was like, "What?" And he's like, "Yeah, like think about it. It's just a margarita with rum." And I was like, "Holy shit, you're right." But it's pretty good. Pretty good, pretty good. Okay. Am I doing this right? Yes, okay. Oh, Matrix 1? Yes. Never really seen it, so I'm excited. Never seen it either, Ghosty? Holy shit. Like, I know, I mean, it's been out for like a fucking century and a half, so like I know like the premise of it and I've seen some scenes. Like I think I might have seen it. Oh my god, my nose is so itchy today. What the fuck? I'm a mess. I'm just a mess and that's a fact. I think I probably saw it when it came out. But I think I was just like so young, I just didn't really care or remember. And like I've said about a million times, my family just wasn't like really big like movie people. So it's not like we were just like watching it over and over again. Fact lurking. Oh my god, hunky! Try to watch Matrix, need to try again. What the heck, dude. I do feel a little bit better that there are other people out there that like haven't really seen it either, so that like makes me feel better. You know what I mean? Just Matrix 1, the other two aren't worth it. Two a bit, great action scenes, story is oof. Oh. Does it just get, like, too weird, or, like, what? You know what I mean? Or is, like, the plot just, like, bad? Way too complicated. Oh. Why would they do that? I don't know. I guess probably just like they had a bunch of ideas and probably just like puked it onto a page. Probably still watch them though. Cause, you know, maybe I'll like them. You never know. ending scene with the architect Matrix 2 took me a good really understand what he's saying. I feel like I feel like Dead quotes the architect, like he'll say stuff, and I have not seen the Matrix 2 like at all ever. Like I 100% know I have not seen that one. I know that the end, I know, like, I don't know if it's even the end, I just know the guy, but I remember the like parody in Scary Movie, I think, was it Scary Movie, where they have like the parody of the architect or whatever. So that's like all I know of it. Super great and good movie on its own. Like, and it, when it ends, does it feel like you need a second one? Or when it ends, is it just like you could live your life without it? But I mean, either way, I'm excited. Also, like, people will be like, red pill, blue pill, and I, like, have never seen the movie, so I'd never know which one's which. I just know that it's from The Matrix. Oh my gosh. I am so itchy in my nose and my head. I must, like, be getting allergies or something. Okay, and then I think after I cut this, I can start like pinning them to sew these. Wait, what's from the Matrix? The red pill, blue pill thing? Like you take this pill to forget this ever happened, and then you take this pill to go down the rabbit hole or something? I don't know. And then also the architect, where he's like, vis-a-vis, ergo, concordantly, whatever. I just remember that was like in Scary Movie or something. Hello? What's happening? Oh. Never mind. It's fine. First one, which is like, there could be more, but it's not needed for a conclusive story. Well, 2 and 3 need to be finished, but 3 is shit, though. Well, who knows? I liked Buster Scruggs, and no one else did, so I might like it. Who knows? But yeah. Dad'll be like, oh, red-pilled, and I'm like, I don't know what the fuck red-pilled even means. I'm gonna be honest with you. Does it mean you've gone to the other side? Is that the one that takes you down the rabbit hole or whatever the fuck they're talking about? I don't know. Red pill gets you out of the Matrix. Blue pill makes you forget about wondering about the Matrix or what's your new life. Okay. I just like, because I haven't really seen it, so I just like never know what the fuck anyone's talking about. Liked all of them. 3 wasn't great, but did enjoy 2. I feel like I'll probably like it okay, you know what I mean? Like, all of them? I don't know. Maybe? Who knows? I don't know. I'm not, like, overly critical about the movies that I watch, necessarily. Like, I'm not really, like, too snobbish, I guess, as far as, like, the plot line and, like, what, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not like a movie critic, and I'm not overly critical or snobbish about movies and storylines and stuff, so I'm not really like super worried about it. I'll probably like it. I mean, one of my favorite fucking types of TV to watch is teen dramas, so like, you know what I mean? Good, not super, great action. Highway scene is iconic. Oh, okay. I don't know. I guess we'll see. I mean, I've never really seen any of them, so I don't really know what to expect. Except I did see that one scene, I think it's in the second one, where, like, they're at, like, a weird underground rave orgy or something. And I just was like, what the fuck are you watching? Because too much CGI. Oh, yeah. I mean, that, like, the CGI stuff doesn't really bug me. I feel like I have a good enough imagination that I don't really care, I guess. You know what I mean? And I think, like, maybe that's why I don't have too much of, like, just try to relax and enjoy a movie. Yeah, I think, like, that's the thing is, like, I know the movie is meant to, like, be enjoyable, and I feel like it has to be particularly bad for me to not enjoy the movie. Oh my god, I have fucking strings everywhere. Whatever. You know what I mean? Like, it has to be super bad for me to not like it. Like, CGI, like, bad CGI doesn't typically, that's not, like, a deal breaker for me. So I don't really care. But, like I said, I'm not, like, a movie critic, I'm not a movie snob or anything. Your movie is bad, but I still enjoyed it. I feel like it is a different thing when it comes to movies based on books, though, that I've read. If it's, like, a book I haven't read, then I probably don't give a shit. But I always notice the most minuscule fucking details. Like, I was watching Hunger Games. Like, and I was watching it, and I remember, like, I had just read the books. Like, I had read all three of the books, like, just finished them, and then the movies came out, like, almost immediately. And I was like, fuck yeah, dude. I remember when Hunger Games came out, and I was reminded of that feeling when they show Prim's fucking cat, and it's, like, black and white in the movie. And I was furious. And I'm like, you couldn't have just found an orange cat? You couldn't have found an orange cat? They're everywhere. You know what I mean? Like, that shit always, like, bugged me when they just change, like, little arbitrary shit where, sure, it's, like, not really important to the story, the fact that the cat is orange or not. But I'm like, it just seems like a detail that, like, to me, I'm like, why would you change it? It's like a detail that's specifically mentioned in the book. Why would you change it? You know what I mean? Like, if it was just a nondescript scraggly cat, I would be like, sure, it's not what I imagined, but they never mentioned a specific color. You know what I mean? Have you watched The Starving Games? I have not. I think that was, like, about the time that, if I remember correctly, like, those parody movies, that's about the time they were, like, kind of, like, at their end, and I was not really watching them anymore. And I'm too scared to watch it now. Because we tried to watch Scary Movie, and I just couldn't do it. So I don't think I could watch The Starving Games, because it's, like, a parody movie, right? Hugo Weaving in Matrix is fucking insanely good as Agent Smith. Dude, that's what Dad always says. Like, Hugo Weaving is just, like, so good. I mean, he's just, like, a good actor, though. So, you know. Okay. Hello? Work texted me, what's happening? Oh. Just giving somebody a shout out, that's cool. Thought they were gonna be like, hey, you fucked something up at work, and I was gonna be like, great. Great. Shkri 900. Hello, welcome, how's it going? What is up? The new Scream looks ace. I have not seen a lot of the, like, classic horror movies, and I think Scream is one of them, like, I haven't really seen. Scary movie, didn't age well at all. No! It just, like, I don't know. There was, like, I think we had talked about this, like, right after we, like, watched it, but they do make, like, a good, like, they made, like, commentary about how, like, they're like, oh, the news is here, like, let's go talk to them. And they're like, they don't want to talk to you, like, they just want to talk to the stupidest person here. And it's like, I feel like everybody just kind of, like, forgot that point was even made, because then what's his face? He's like the, like, idiot brother or whatever, and he's like talking to the police and he's like stoned. And so because they, like, immediately make a joke after that, that whatever the fuck his name is, like, the stupidest person there, I think people forget that, like, the point they made was, like, the media outlets don't want to talk to anyone who has anything real to say. They want to talk to the stupidest person there. So, like, I think there are probably, like, some good commentary in it, but I just think that humor is just, like, gone and done, you know? At least for me, it's like gone. A scary movie, best to worst. JD is a poor judge on this, whatever. 2, 1, 3, 4, 5. Oh my god. I don't know if I could. If one is, like, your number two, I don't think I could watch them. Three is good and funny, even if the movie is parodying or bad. I want to say, if I remember correctly, when the third one came out, I think that was one that I really liked. I think that one was my favorite when it came out. But I would be willing to bet if I watched it now, I probably would not think so. Four and five are shit. I don't even remember. I feel like, if I remember correctly, I agree with you. But I don't really remember them, like, what they were about, you know what I mean? Three has Liam Neeson, the president. You can't beat that. I don't know. I just don't think I could do the parody movies anymore. I think that, like, I've just, you know what I mean? And not, like, a judgment on anyone that, like, enjoys them. Like, I think that's, like, fine. Like, whatever. I just think that it's just not something I'm into anymore. So, I just don't think I can find any enjoyment in them anymore. I don't enjoy parody movies very much. But I've seen them as Mr. Bookish enjoys them. I just, yeah. Like, I would sit through one, but I think that I would prefer to not. You know? Mel Brooks does parody movies and they're still funny 20 years ago. What? Like what? Like what movie? And if you say Basketball, I'm gonna freak out. I don't know if that's a movie of his, but Audie, I think by the time 3 was made, they should have put the brakes on making more. Dude, but they, like, didn't stop making more. They made so many of them. There was, like, 6,000. Young Frankenstein? I don't think I've ever. Dude, Halloween's just around the corner, baby. Robin Hood, Men in Tights. I didn't think that Robin Hood Men in Tights was very good. I'm just gonna say that. I didn't enjoy that one very much. Spaceballs? I don't think I've seen Spaceballs. Yeah, that's just a fact, dude. audience that they were like, hold my beer, watch this. That's like the, oh god, yeah. Yeah, I mean, that's really accurate. Didn't care much for Spaceballs, sorry, JD. Yeah, Robin Hood Men in Tights didn't really, like, do it for me. It seemed too... I think maybe because I didn't enjoy it in the time, maybe that it was, like, popular, or, like, when it was, like, kind of, you know, like, in fashion to, like, watch it. Maybe that's why. Like, I never, like, the first time I saw it was, like, what, this past year? I just felt a little bit too try hard to me. Like, it didn't feel like easy breezy funny. It felt like they were trying like so hard to make it funny that it kind of lost its humor for me. So, unpopular opinion, that's fine. I did not like it. Ow. No, I liked Monty Python and the Holy Grail. That's like, that's not fair. I liked it. I thought that was good. I liked the humor in that one. The Robin Hood Men in Tights just seemed like it was trying too hard. Probably you didn't see the Robin Hood Prince of Thief because that's the main movie it's parodying. No, I didn't. But also, do you think it makes a difference? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know. I know. I know the Dread Pirate Roberts is in that movie. I know Wesley's in it. And I love him as Wesley. Love, in love with him as Wesley. As Robin Hood, my heart was broken. My heart was broken, I'm sorry. That's just the fact of it. Ow, fuck, god damn it. Okay. Oh, wow, this is taking a long time. Like I said, this is like so tedious. But at least it'll be all nice and all the shit will be encased and it will look good. The other parts, though, like I said, I'm gonna lazy it up. Prince of Thieves classic. I'll give it a whirl. I'm not making any promises. Like, I'm just saying, there's, like, certain comedy that I just don't... It has to be done in such a way for me to find it funny. So, you know. Like, if it's just like, I don't know, like the stupid, like dumb humor, like just doesn't really like do it for me anymore. It's like lost a little bit of its magic. You're getting set up right now? Oh, hell yeah. Dude, let me know. Okay. Sorry, I'm getting, like, excited, so I'm getting, like, kind of loud. Let me know when you go live, because I don't know if I'll get notified, just regular notified. I don't know if I'll get notified, so just, like, hit me up, and then we'll raid you, and it'll be, like, a fucking party. I'm excited. I'm so fucking excited. As soon as Dead told me that you wanted to start streaming and that you wanted to maybe stream today, I was like, hell yeah. And I was like around what time? And he was like, oh, she said around like 11. And I was like our time? And he's like, I think so. And I was like, so, I was like, I'll be done. Show you my raid sound. He did. I'm so fucking excited, dude. I'm so excited. And I was like, I don't think I'll be streaming that late. And so I kind of was like, not really too upset about starting later. Cause I was like, well, maybe Ghosty will show up today and I'll ask her about it. But yeah, let me know when you go live and then we'll, cause he did say that, the liar. I feel like she must've meant like 11 o'clock her time. Because it's got to be close to 11 your time, right, Ghosty? Oh my god, Ghosty, 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 Ghosty. Okay, I didn't get a chance to tell you last night in Deadstream because at work I wasn't, like, logged in when you said it. And so by the time I, like, got everything, like, logged in, like, it was kind of, like, too late to say anything. But you had said you had a dream, and I don't remember if I told you this or not, but you said you had a dream that you, like, came to our house, right? And, like, we're watching this horror movie, like, whatever. It is. It actually is 11 here. Okay, well, then I was thinking maybe that's what... when it was 11, she said around this time. Okay, I mean... it's, like, around that time, you know? In 3 hours, it'll be 11 o'clock here, p.m. Anyway, okay. So you were talking about having a dream about us, right, and coming to our house. So a couple months ago... I had a dream that we flew to Japan and, like, we were like, oh, well, we're, like, in the area. We should go say hi to Ghosty. And so I, like, it was so weird because, like, I have not done this, but this sounds really creepy. But I had this dream. So we get to Japan and I was like, oh, well, I'll just go onto Facebook and I'll find her and, like, hit her up. And, like, let her know that, like, we're here. And then we're like, oh, we could just, like, go eat. Like, I don't know. It was, like, the most fucking bizarre dream I've ever had in my life. Because I was like, that's weird. I was like, it's weird that, like, we'd be traveling to that specific area. You know what I mean? And then, like, I'm like, how would I even, like, look her up? Like, I don't even, like, know her, like, whole real name. I don't know. It was weird. But I was going to tell you that I had that dream when you were talking about it. But then by the time I got logged in, I was like, this feels weird to just be like, oh, yeah, by the way, I had a dream about you. But yeah, I just thought that was, like, funny that you had a dream about us. And then, like, a couple months ago, I had a dream that we went to your house. But yeah, that's my story. Yeah, it was, like, weird too, because I was like, in my dream, I was like, well, maybe she's a part of, like, a Facebook group. Because I think in my dream, I was like, well, I'll just look her up on Facebook. Then I was like, I don't know her, like, her whole name. And I was like, but I think that if she's part of, like, a Facebook group, that, like, I'll just, like, look her up on a Facebook group. I don't know. It was, like, weird. Having a hard time figuring out this multiple screen thing. What's okay? What's happening? Give me a play-by-play, Ghosty. Can Sunburn help you out? Is Sunburn technologically inclined? Because, like, it depends what you're trying to do. Because if you're playing games, you'll just have to have everything on your other screen. To be fair, there's a ton of Facebook pages here. I think that's why in my dream, that's what I was, like, thinking. I was like, oh, I'll just find her on a Facebook group. But yeah, I just thought that was, like, funny. You know what I mean? No sound. Okay. Are you playing games or are you doing art? I just am gonna have a lot of questions for you to answer. I apologize. Okay, I'm getting... this sweater was a terrible idea. It's really cozy, but it's getting caught on all of these pins. Let me see if I can, like, roll it up or something. How to get Photoshop onto my tablet screen. Wait, I got it. I was gonna say, I think it just kind of depends on, like, are you doing it on... I don't know. There's, like, so many options. If there's an exit button, click that. Great advice, hunky. Thank you. We can always count on you. Because I was gonna say, there's, like, probably a few options of, like, maybe having your tablet, like, plugged into your computer. But I don't know. I think it just depends on a lot of things. Yeah, thanks, Lunky. Great advice. What's happening? Oh, here we go. I almost just, like... okay. So much fabric. Okay. But yeah, once you get it started up, let me know, dog. Send you my new Kraft mac and cheese flavor boost packs. Dude, what the hell? What is a boost pack? Like, what on earth? That sounds wild. You can only get in Canada. Ooh, what are the what are the Canadian flavors they have? What do they got going on over there? That's what I want to know. I poked myself with one of these pins like right in the wrist. It feels like a little bit itchy. Never seen it. What? Love the powdered cheese it is. Dude, maybe Audie can help you out. JD's like, I've never eaten mac and cheese in my life. Ow, fucking goddamn. Okay. All of these are like stabbing me. Okay. Cotton candy, ghost pepper, and others. Oh my god. Cotton candy, mac and cheese? No way. Why? That's psychotic. I'm sorry. I don't mean to be offensive to the Canadian culture, but cotton candy mac and cheese is the weirdest thing. Ew. No. That's weird. That's just weird. What are you guys doing in Canada? You know what I mean? Like, what's going on up there? You guys okay? That's just bizarre. McDonald's in Canada has a grilled cheese Happy Meal. What? It's not because they try to sell us shit that we love it. Dude, I'm just asking, what's going on? Like, you guys okay? Do you guys need help? Blink twice if you're in trouble. Velveeta mac and cheese? Dude, I only really like I'm not like a big mac and cheese fan. I don't really like it. I think it's just like too much cheese. You know what I mean? However, if it's homemade, I'll eat it, but if it's, like, from a box, I typically won't eat it. Freaks me out too much. Okay. For the original, cotton candy sounds fucking vile. Dude, that's what I'm saying. Like, who said that was a thing anyone wanted? Okay, gonna start so I can post links and stuff. Take your time with the stream though. Sounds good. Dude, I'm so excited for you to stream. So fucking excited. But yeah, I don't know if you're on my Discord or not, Ghosty, but I know in Dead's Discord you can post in like the Twitch like promo board or whatever your channel, and then Ghosty is in there already? Wait, where? Because I was going to say, I also have a Twitch promo board if you wanted to also post in there, but I am there. Okay. I like couldn't... Oh yeah, you are in my Discord. What the fuck am I even saying? Do you ever just like... Okay. So I only... Okay, weird thing. So this morning when I was like, oh, I'll just DM Ghosty on Discord, right? And I was like trying to like find you, but for some reason I couldn't like search you in Discord. And I was like, fucking weird. I guess I'll just have to like find her having commented somewhere on Discord, right? And then it goes mutual Discords, like the fiend layer. And I was like, oh, weird. I thought she was in my Discord. And I was like, I must be mistaken. So for some reason I had it in my head that you weren't on my Discord. Now I'm like thinking about it and I'm like, I fucking talked to you on there. I'm like, what the fuck, dude? My brain is so easily manipulated. I would probably join a cult if I were offered. haven't eaten McDonald's in over a year. McDonald's makes stuff according to region. Yeah, dude. The Japanese McDonald's always has such good shit there. Oh, so good. They had like these like, okay, I think they were like chocolate fries or something, which sounds really gross, but it's not. Pretty sure they had like chocolate fries, but and then they also, during springtime, Sakura flavored fucking everything, dude. I miss Sakura flavored everything in the springtime. That's like some good shit, dude. Okay, come on. Last there like 16 years ago. Wait, what? Haven't eaten McDonald's in years because it's gross. I mean, that's fair. That's a fair assessment. Kind of fast food in general is pretty gross, so I'll give you that. Okay, sunburned, but have you had Japanese McDonald's though? You know what I mean? Like, because certainly you've gone there, you don't like it? Like, what the heck, man? For pepper lunch? Pepper lunch is divine. Pepper lunch is the food of the gods. I miss Japanese food so fucking much. Like, Japanese fast food is incredible. Like, Sukiya, delicious. Coco's, delicious. Even like the American like fast food that is in Japan is like way better. We went to, I want to say it was like, was it a Wendy's? It was either a Wendy's or a Burger King. And they had this like decadent ass like avocado burger with like this like grilled sesame bun or something. I don't know. It was like insane and it was like really decadent and like fancy. And I was like, you would never get this in the US. Like, they would never make anything. It was like a gourmet burger. It was like insane. But yeah, Japanese food is incredible. And I have to at least like go back once, I think. Just to see, you know what I mean? Just to try it out. Dude, what the fuck? Why can I not find you, Ghosty? What is going on? I wanted to like leave a lurk on your channel so I could monitor it like a fucking psycho crazy person. Due to Omicron, that makes me so... Wait, what? Dude, that's bullshit. That's bullshit.
That is bullshit. And that's my story about that. Oh, fuck yeah. Okay. All right, so here's the plan, Stans. Okay, I'm gonna finish pinning this one little thing here. Ghosty is fucking live and her starting soon screen is like too fucking cute. I would starve in Japan, but I enjoy the sights until I did. There's food that you can eat for sure, bookish. I'm sure of it. I'm sure there's something you could eat there. But yeah, I'm gonna finish pinning up this little guy here, because I know if I stop in the middle, I just won't. You don't, why? I thought you liked soup. They have lots of soups around for eating. So tomorrow I'm going to stream. They have celery. I can eat raw celery. Pretty sure they do. That feels like a thing they have. Also, celery probably isn't going. Soup with so many things I don't eat. Okay. How do you know? Have you ever tried miso soup? I was gonna say, celery, like, you will die. You will eat celery and you will die. And that's just, like, a fact. No noodles, no eggs, seafood, or fish. Okay, but what about miso, though? Right, miso soup, sometimes it has seaweed in it, but you don't have to have seaweed in it. Miso has so many nutrients in it. I don't know if you could survive on it, but... yeah, celery actually, it costs more calories to eat than it has in it. So you like it burns more calories to consume celery than it does, like, than celery contains. Just fun fact. So I think you would still unfortunately starve to death with celery, but you'd be really hydrated probably. What about dumplings? You like dumplings? You got the Discord notification for Ghosty. That's exciting. Okay. All right. So here is the plan. Everybody is already over there, but we'll give Ghosty a raid. Tomorrow I'm going to stream probably earlier, probably around like 3:30, I'm guessing. Nothing but celery for a year? Dude, how? I don't understand. That's your... You're a modern medical miracle. Bookish. That's like crazy. Okay. So, again, looked at miso. Maybe I could try it. Yeah, because you could just like take the stuff out of miso soup, because miso soup is like actually like really high in nutrients and stuff. Anyway. Streaming tomorrow, probably around 3:30. I'll let you guys know. I don't know what I'll be doing tomorrow. Maybe we could sew this up. I don't know. It depends how I feel. I'll let you guys know tomorrow. But thank you guys for hanging out. I'm excited to see you tomorrow. And I am excited to go to Ghosty's stream. Goodbye.
Yeah, we were gonna raid, but now I have to treat the pups, so hopefully we make it in time, Ghosty, or, Hunky. If we miss the raid, it's Hunky's fault. I just want you guys to know that. Alright, puppies, come here. Up, up, up. This is from Hunky. He wants us to miss the raid for Ghosty because he wants to watch the world burn. For Afreya. And for an Isaac. Good job, puppies. Okay, for real though, goodbye. I love you. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Let's go say hi to Ghosty. Goodbye.